हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज ऑटो कॉलिमेटर। सो वी कैन से दैट दिस ऑटो कॉलिमेटर इज अ स्पेशल फॉर्म ऑफ टेलीस्कोप विच इज यूज टू मेजर स्मॉल एंगल्स विथ हाई डिग्री ऑफ रेजोल्यूशन। सो इट इज अ small form of telescope which is used to measure small angles with high degree of resolution. Not only measuring the angles, this autocollimator is used for various applications like precision alignment, verification of angle standards, and detection of angular movement. So if you want to align any object or any component in a assembly, you can use this autocollimator, which can provide precision alignment. It is used to verify angle, verify angle standards, and detection of angular movements. So this autocollimator, it projects a beam of collimated light on a reflector, which is deflected by a small angle about the vertical plane. So it will first collimate the light and it will project it on to a reflector. So after it is projected on the reflector, it will be deflected by a small angle. That is, the light will be deflected by a small angle about the vertical plane. The deflection between the beam and the reflected beam is the measure of the angular tilt of the reflector. So the deflection between the beam, that is the beam of light, and the reflected beam of light, is the measure of angular tilt of the reflector. So here this diagram gives the principle of working of an autocollimator. So the reticle is an illuminated target with a crosshair pattern, which is positioned in the focal plane of an objective lens. So here there is a crosshair reticle. So it will have two cross lines, something like this. So this reticle is the illuminated target, which is positioned in the focal plane of an objective lens. So that is, this reticle is positioned such that it is in focal plane of this objective lens. So this is the objective lens which is shown in the figure. So there is a plane mirror which is perpendicular to the optical axis that serves the purpose of reflecting an image of the pattern back onto the observation point. So there is a mirror which will reflect back the image of the pattern back onto the observing point. So here there is the observer, and the mirror which is present here, and it is perpendicular to the optical axis. So if this is the optical axis, there is a mirror which is perpendicular to this axis, that is at 90 degrees to this axis. The objective of this mirror is to reflect back the image of the pattern to the observing point. So here again we will get an image of the reflected image of the pattern which is reflected back. There is a reticle. So, then a viewing system is required to observe the relative position of the image of the cross wires. So, there must be a viewing system which is required to observe the relative position of the cross wires. So, in most of the autocollimators, this is done by using a simple eyepiece. So, here there will be an eyepiece from which we will observe the reflected image. So, if the plane reflector is rotated by an angle theta, then it will result in the displacement of the image by an amount. So, if d is equals to displacement, then d can be written as 2f into theta, where f is the focal length of the objective lens. So, if this plane reflector is rotated by an angle theta, then the image which is forming will be displaced by an amount. If d is the displacement of the image, then it will be deflected by an amount 2 into small f into theta, where small f is the focal length of the objective lens. So, it is clear from this relationship, that is the displacement is equals to 2 into f theta, that the sensitivity of an autocollimator depends on the focal length of the objective lens. If the focal length is larger, then the linear displacement for the given tilt of the plane reflector will also be large. So, this instrument is very sensitive. It is so much sensitive that the air currents between the optical path and the target mirror can cause deflections in the readings obtained. So, even the air currents which are present between the optical path and the target mirror can cause deflections in the readings. So, this instrument is very sensitive. So, this effect, that is the sensitivity, will increase a lot when the distance between the optical path and the target mirror is very high or it increases. So, that is why this autocollimator is housed inside a steel metal or a PVC plastic casing, so that the air currents will not hamper the measurement accuracy. So, this autocollimator can be classified into three types. The first one is the visual or conventional autocollimator. The second one is the digital autocollimator. The third and the last one is the laser autocollimator. Now, let us discuss them one by one. The first one, that is the visual or conventional autocollimator. So, in this type of autocollimator, the displacement of the reflected image is determined visually. So, as we have seen, the principle of working of a conventional collimator, so the displacement of the reflected image is seen with our eyes. A pinhole light source is used whose reflected image is absorbed by the operator through an eyepiece. So, here in this visual autocollimator, a pinhole light source is used. So, The reflected image is observed by the operator through the eyepiece, and this collimator uses pinhole light source. Visual collimators are typically focused at infinity, making them useful for both short and long distance measurement. So these are usually focused at infinity. Because of which they are suitable for both short and long measurements, long distance measurement. So the plane reflector or the mirror is a vital part of a collimator, because if the mirror is not flat, then it will defocus the return image and resulting in poor definition of the image. High quality mirrors with a flatness tolerance of 1 micrometer per 100 mm are used. So, because it will affect the accuracy of measurement, we have to use very high quality mirrors with flatness tolerance of 1 micrometer per 100 mm are used. So the typical applications of visual collimators are being discussed now. So this autocollimator can determine angular measurement up to 3 inches. It can determine the straightness of machine guideways. So not only angular measurement but also straightness of machine guideways. It can determine parallelism of slide movements with respect to guideways. So when a slide is moving on the guideways, we can check whether it is, the movement is parallel to the guideways or not. It can estimate the flatness of machine tables and surface plates. Angle comparison of reflecting surfaces can be made. The last one, that is the verification of right angle prisms for angular errors. We can verify right angle prisms for angular errors. So this is all about the visual autocollimator. The next type which we have seen is the digital autocollimator. So a digital autocollimator uses an electronic photo detector to detect the reflected light beam. So we are not directly observing the reflected light beam through the eyepiece, but we are using a electronic photo detector to check or to detect the reflected light beam. So the advantage of this type of collimator is that it uses a digital signal processing technology to detect and process the reflected beam. So here, digital signal processing technology is used. So because of this use of this digital signal processing technology, it will filter out the stray scattered light, and the image which we obtain will be very sharp and clear. So in this type of autocollimator, that is the digital autocollimator, the illuminated target reticle, that is a slit of the reticle, is imaged back in its own plane through the objective lens and the reflecting mirror. Then it is re-imaged on a vibrating slit by means of a relay lens. So here we have already seen the principle of working of the autocollimator. We have seen that there is a reticle slit which is the illuminated target. So the image in this digital autocollimator, the image of this reticle is imaged back in its own plane through the objective lens and the reflecting mirror. After it is imaged back in its own axis, it is re-imaged onto a vibrating slit by means of a relay lens. So a photocell is positioned behind this vibrating slit, and that photocell will generate an output. The output is both the magnitude and the direction of rotation of the mirror from the central null position. So a photocell is placed behind this vibrating slit, and this photocell will generate the output, which is both the magnitude and direction of rotation of the mirror from its central null position. So these instruments have a resolution of up to 0.01 arc second and linearity of 0.1%. So because this data or the output which we obtain is in digital form, it can be transferred to the data storage system where we can store it and we can process the data further. So some of the applications of digital autocollimator. The first one is the angular measurement of static as well as dynamic systems. So not only static systems, this digital autocollimator can measure the angles of even dynamic systems. The second one is the alignment and monitoring of robotic axis. So it can verify the angular errors of rotary tables, indexing heads, and platforms of machine parts. The last application is it is useful or it is used in remote monitoring of alignment of large mechanical systems. So it can monitor the alignment of large mechanical systems. The next one is the laser autocollimator. So laser autocollimator represents future of precision angle measurement in the industry. So it is used for precision angular measurements. Superior intensity of this laser beam makes it ideal for measurement of angles of very small objects. So objects of 1 mm in diameter also can be measured, that is the angle of the objects which are small as 1 mm in diameter also can be measured by using this laser autocollimator. Even large objects like width 15 meter also can be measured by this laser autocollimator. Another very useful advantage of this laser autocollimator is that it can be used for measurement of non-mirror quality surfaces also. So many autocollimators we have seen, visual autocollimator and digital autocollimators, they can measure only the mirror quality surfaces. But here, laser autocollimator can be used to measure non-mirror surfaces, quality surfaces also. So this laser beam has a very high intensity and it will create ultra low noise measurement and increases the accuracy of measurement. So here we can see a figure of the laser autocollimator. So all the components of the laser autocollimator are housed in a precisely machined barrel. So there is a barrel in which these all the components are placed. The line of sight, in this case, the laser beam. So there is a laser beam and this beam is precisely cantered. How it is cantered? Because of the holding and the supporting fixtures. The laser beam is produced by continuous wave plasma tube. So there is a laser plasma tube in which the laser beam is continuously produced. This plasma tube is coherent and it has a diameter of approximately 8 to 10 mm. So this optical axis of the laser beam is exactly in line with the mechanical axis of the barrel. So as I have told you, this all the objects or all the components of the laser beam are placed inside a mechanical barrel. So the axis of this laser beam is in line with the axis of that mechanical barrel. The rear lens, along with this pinhole cell or the spatial filter, will ensure sharp images or sharp beam. This laser beam is aimed at the target. The instrument barrel, in addition to the laser emitter, contains a beam splitter and an arrow of photoelectric sensor. So, along with the laser emitter, there is a beam splitter, which is here. The beam splitter prism is present and an array of photoelectric sensors. So this is bicell detector, that is the photoelectric sensor. There is an array of these sensors present inside this instrument barrel. So they are arranged in such a way that they do not receive the laser emissions, but they receive only the return beam from the mirror. So this beam splitter and array of photoelectric sensors are arranged such that they receive only the return beam from the mirror. So in the laser autocollimator, the internal target is the bicell array of sensors. So here this bicell array of sensor is the internal target. So two such sensors are provided to measure the displacement in each axis. The sensor output is converted into angular displacement by logical circuit. So these sensors, that is the bicell array sensors, will measure the displacement in each axis. So two sensors are provided to measure displacement in each axis. Now the sensor will give an output which will be converted to angular displacement by the logical circuit. So laser collimators have a resolution of plus or minus 3 arc seconds. So this is all about the CMM and autocollimator. Thank you.